ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఃఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వీవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 7 ఆఫ్ 7th చాప్టర్. వర్స్ నంబర్ 7 ఆఫ్ 7th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ మత్త పరతరం నాన్యత్ కించిదస్తి ధనంజయన్ మయి సర్వమిదం ప్రోతం సూత్రే మణిగణాయవ. ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ సెషన్ వి సో ద గాడ్ కాన్సెప్ట్ షుడ్ బి రియలైజ్డ్ త్రూ 3 స్టెప్స్. హ్యావింగ్ దాట్ ఐడియా as the foundation, we can just go through the teaching of Lord Krishna. Krishna says there are 2 kinds of principles, higher and lower. Then higher principle is known as para prakriti, lower principle is known as apara prakriti, and this apara prakriti depends on para prakriti. This para prakriti, which is in the form of chetanam, consciousness, this consciousness, it all pervades in all apara prakriti part. Now this para and apara are mixed together, that's what is the cause of this creation. This means the gross world, that's what we saw in the last session. And this prakriti tattva, you know, when we call it prakriti tattva, prakriti tattva means the material cause or the creation which had happened as the 5 elemental world. And this 5 elemental world cannot be measured. Even there is a story, Brahmaji, he tried to measure it, but he was not able to measure because it is anadi. So when this para prakriti evolved as a creation, no time. But we fix the time, the world has got this many millenniums. This whole account is not perfect. Nobody can fix the account. Even our Puranas, they fix their own time. We have 4 yugas. Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dvapara Yuga and Kali Yuga. And these Yugas, they have their own accounts, the count of the years. But according to the philosophy, means the truth or fact of this Maya Tattva, I mean Apara Prakriti and Para Prakriti, it cannot be calculated because it is beyond the time. Whatever that our mind can understand, that has to be measured by time and space. In the srishti alone, that too, the grossified srishti alone has the time and space. For example, a dreamer's time completely differs from a waker's time. And these both, dreamer and the waker's time, differs from sleeper's time. In the dream, what happens? Within 1.5 minutes, we are born and we go to school, colleges, we finish exams, means we get certificates, we get married, we own children and the children are got married and you become old. So all these phenomena happens within 1.5 minutes, isn't it? The wakers, he takes 80 years to complete his life. But dreamer has got, if we compare from the standpoint of waker, dreamer has got 1.5 minutes alone. Now my question, which is true? So you have the capacity to live whole life within 1.5 minutes, isn't it? That dreamer has got the glory to cover whole life within 1.5 minutes. I say 1.5 minutes because that is the maximum time of the dream, because science has developed that much by having this rapid eyes during the sleep. They consider that is the time of duration of the dream. Now this whole life, 80 years. In the 80 years, we sleep at least for 20 years. I'm calculating minimum, because many people cannot sleep more than 6 hours. Now this sleep has got its own duration. 6 hours or 8 hours, it goes like very, you know, very short period. It's completely opposite to the dreamer. So dreamer swallows 80 years as a living being. He has got so many experiences, but this sleeper means a person who sleeps, who experiences the sleep, he swallows, means he becomes completely ignorant for all the duration of the sleep. Now his experience about the life is completely zero. There is a difference. In the same way, this para prakriti becomes the witness of this all waking, dreaming and sleeping state. A waker, dreamer, sleeper becomes apara prakriti as the experiences. Now this duration cannot be calculated, because that's what the glory of apara prakriti and para prakriti. Even para prakriti alone becoming witness, but in the para prakriti there is no time, there is no space. Our body has got the time and space, because today morning you woke up, and after that you did so many things, and you cannot be at one place. You have to keep moving. If at all you are sitting for one place, doesn't matter, you cannot sit in other places. Space wise you are limited, and time wise you are limited. You can be at present, you have the past and future, but this past and future and present is only to your mind, not even for this body. It's a kind of a mixer. The body has limited by time and space, but it is not conscious of that. Even body doesn't have the death. This is what nowadays the science is concluding, because when you take a liver from a person who is about to die, our heart or this retina of the eyes, if it is fixed with another body, it goes up to his lifespan of time. It means the calculation about the body, calculation about the mind, even mind doesn't decay, the mind is carried to another body. That's what our understanding is. Now whole apara prakriti consists the modifications like this. This apara prakriti has got all kinds of recollections, experience, daytime, nighttime, dream time. So all these experience belongs to apara prakriti. This apara prakriti doesn't have, because it is being limited by time and space, it doesn't have to calculate time and space. Being a Ishvara, the Ishvara himself keeps what? Beyond than time and space. Therefore we cannot calculate. So I'm you know, telling you in different way so that you could understand how this concept is being launched. In a day-to-day life you can imply it. Now what I would like to say is, we cannot measure when the world was created. That's what I'm saying, because our body is subject to time and space. Mind is subject to time and space. It means it cannot think beyond time and space. But if you have a kind of methodology, a specific method which is known as parampara vidya, Parampara means from the lineage you get a method to approach a particular subject matter. That approachment helps you to digest. Now you see, we can say we are beyond time and space, or we are limited, our body is limited, but you are not limited. So when I say like this, you can understand something. If I would have told in the beginning chapter itself, in the first chapter itself, so you will keep yourself mum and you will be only blinking your eyes, isn't it? That is what the secret of Srishti. You live in the present, but your mind and body calculates means they have to change according to the time and space. So with that calculation, you cannot calculate from the standpoint of waking calculation to dreaming calculation. No, therefore we have to understand as it is. Yes, world is as the apara prakriti. That's all. So one word will give a complete understanding. Apara prakriti means what? It has the forms, that forms keeps on changing. It is also called anadi. Anadi means what? We cannot measure the limitation of apara prakriti even. And para prakriti is all pervasive. When I say all pervasive, what you get understanding? All pervasive, like an oil which is in sesame seed, isn't it? So that it is all pervasive. Sugar, the sweetness of the sugar, it is all pervasive in the sugar. If I say that, that's what we understand. I all pervade my body, my consciousness is all pervasive. So in that way, we somehow realize. Okay, he says, aham krishnasya jagatah prabhava pralayas tatha. I am the place, ground for whole jagat. And jagat has got two phenomena. It comes into manifestation and it goes into unmanifestation. We don't call it creation. Creation means what? Coming into name and form is known as manifestation. The creation is the manifestation. The creation means a pot maker, when he makes the pot is manifested. That manifestation happens every day in our day-to-day life. When we wake up, we manifest ourselves. In other words, Vedantic word is there, it's a projection. It's a kind of self-projection. I project the world and I resolve the world. It is possible. My world is projected by me and my world is being dissolved or resolved by me. Or in other words, the projection of my world, I am the ground for the resolution of my world. I am the ground. In the same way, Ishvara says, this I, which is experienced by every jiva, is none other than para prakriti. This apara prakriti goes into para prakriti and comes into manifestation again. Isn't it? Now, every day there is prabhavaha, means creation, and pralayaha, resolution. I am the author of creation and the resolution. Every thought, when it manifests, and the thought gets also resolved. This is what the way of approaching Srishti and Sthiti. It is manifested. It will go in a day to unmanifested form. Avyaktadini bhutani vyaktamadhyani bharata avyaktanidhanan eva tatrakapari devana. So now, these words, it says, the world was in the unmanifested form, it is manifested in between, and it will go again in unmanifested form, then it will come back. It goes and comes back, goes and comes back. That's what we calculate this aparaprakriti as manifestation and manifestation. That is the nature of aparaprakriti. It goes to unmanifestation and comes to manifestation. So that's what our experience, because it is manifested now. I cannot say that it manifests and unmanifests. Now it is being manifested. Now the next phenomenon, this body should go into unmanifested form, then it will come again. So I remain as the author of manifestation and unmanifestation, because the Ishvara is all-pervaded entity which is in the form of Paraprakriti, which is experienced as I. It means what? I remains as the ground. All the body, mind, sense complex, they are manifested and unmanifested. They are projected and resolved. That's what the secret. Swamiji, by understanding this, what would be the benefit we get? What is the benefit more than this? You get complete clarity about Srishti. You can see your manifestation, your unmanifestation every day, isn't it? That is wonder. You cannot stop that circle or cycle. That cycle happens what? It will happen. That is the nature of it. You cannot stop it. If you want to come away from that, that is possible. Once you undergo the teaching under a guru of Shastra, you can withdraw from the cycle, because that cycle will be on. You cannot stop the cycle. You need not to stop it. So Srishti will be having, Srishti will be taking place forever, and Pralaya will be taking place. Therefore, body is manifested and resolved. The world is manifested and resolved. Every object is manifested and resolved. If you want to get away, you can jump. You have to jump out. Therefore, once a person attains the knowledge, he could jump out. So jumping out means what? That's what freedom, liberation. He can jump out. Now, after jumping out, what will remain? That we will see. We have so many chapters. The Srishti has got its own method, its own way of manifesting, unmanifesting the things. But you become the base. You become the substratum of manifestation, unmanifestation. It means what? You become the center, because being a part, being not a part, because that I is only one. That's what it is said in the next words, that I, which is experienced in you as your own I, is the I experienced by all the body. That's all. Swamiji, it's a little bit confusing. No, make a simple example. You take 10 mirrors, small, one by one, okay? So you take that mirror, which is 1 square feet, one by one, and place them on the terrace, okay? And wait for 12 o'clock in the noon. So when sun comes at the top, now you look in the mirrors, how many suns are there? So if there is 10 suns, including one sun which is original, okay? Now these suns, the size of the sun, is it the same size which original sun has? No, but it is reflected. The medium is reflected. So you just break the sun, you will find a complete sun everywhere. Isn't it? Now my question, the sun is reflected in every mirror. Is it one or many? That's all complete, Vedanta. We call it Pratibimbavadaha. The consciousness is one. The bodies are many. Bodies are medium in which you can find the reflection. According to our karmapala, means according to para prakriti, the upadhis, the mediums, they differ. But the entity which is reflected, the consciousness, why we use the word reflection means we found ourselves. Nobody told that you have, my dear, you have one eye which is experienced as yourself. That is what we name Raghava, Madhava, Madhusudana, Harikesha, Hrishikesha. So these all names we are naming any, you know, any parents, did they say that? Or do they say at present? No, never, just their name. We understand, okay. So I am Madhava. So that's what self-understanding is. The self is experienced, it is found. That it is found as the reflected one, that's what Vedanta says. It's a found as the reflected one, but that reflected one has got, it is supported by original one. That we will see later, you know. For the time being, this much understanding is enough. That's what he comes. Let us read the next words. Mattah parataram anyat kinchidasti dhananjaya mayi sarvamidam protam sutre manigana iva. Mayi sarvam idam protam. As I told you, know this, all this manifestation is what is that, connected with me, or I become inherent subject in all the manifestation. Now my question, in the first line, we have to understand the first line, then we will come to the next line. He says, this para prakriti and apara prakriti. So I am the para prakriti and apara prakriti. And this doesn't have one more cause. He said, this para and apara is the cause of this grossified creation. But these two, they don't have any cause. It means I don't have any cause. I don't have any parents. I am the supreme parent to all. There is no anything beyond me. Mataha parataram nasti. I don't have any cause. Parataram means one more cause. If you ask anybody, so how you are being created because of my parents, they would have their own parents. So everyone, they don't have their cause, is the similar. It looks every object has got its own cause. A mango sapling caused by mango seed. In the same way, there is banana sapling, it is caused by banana tree alone. So it seems to be that every object has got their own cause, that the cause of all the object, they are differing one each other. But he says, so I am the cause of everything, I don't have cause. This all material cause is because of me alone. They look different, but they are not different. For me, I am the material cause of all. And for me, I am the para prakriti. It means what? He alone exists. And also, in him alone, everything is connected, like you take the garland. In the garland, so many beads are there. The beads are connected with the thread which is inherent in the bead. You take so many parts. The parts are made up of clay. And now there seems to be many parts. And all parts are caused by same clay. Same clay means the same material. You can make different part from the different clay. You can make varieties of pot with the same amount of clay. The clay is the same in all pot. Now we can use that sarvam idam protam. Protam means it is weaved. When there is a weaving, so that weaving, a cloth has got its own thread. We call it yarn. Like that, this garland is connected, but the thread is not visible, only beads are visible. In the same way, every creature, they appear, they are individual creature, but all of them are connected to me. From the standpoint of para prakriti, from the aspect of apara prakriti, everything is connected with me. Therefore, we are completely connected with the totality. That is what the understanding. It means what? You are not alone, not alone, not alone. Because we have that feeling, I am alone. I don't have anybody. So I had my parents after the parents whom I have. After getting married, even people feel that loneliness. I have to take care of myself. They separate themselves from this Ishvara. Ishvara exists. He is existing as inherent in all the objects. We are connected. All the creatures are connected. Every single bit means a pinch of a point of grass. Even it is connected to huge phenomenon. It means what? I am connected with the nature. I am the nature. I am connected with that power, supreme power. I am the supreme power. You won't find the difference thereafter. These words has to be understood a little bit more, that we will continue in the next session tomorrow, in the next episode. हरिः ओम् ओम् पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम् शान्तिः 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 हरिः ओम् श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम्